transverse binary fission, we are seeing into the paramecium. Transverse binary fission into the paramecium. First we see this is a slipper animalcule, reconsideration as a paramecium. Paramecium is completely oriented by the small hair-like projections, we call as cilia, is completely there. Here there is have a cytostome, is a cytopharynx, and here anterior part, one of the contractile vacuole, we called as anterior contractile vacuole. Second one is goes to one more vacuole, we called as a posterior contractile vacuoles. Here we called as two nucleus we are seeing. One is goes to macronucleus, is goes to multiple. It is goes to micronucleus, is goes to diploid state, is multiple phase, so diploid phase, isn't it? The cytoplasm will be there. This is a paramecium structures. When this is goes to divides, undergoes to divides, is attack, means basically it is a favorable conditions is performed by this type of transfer binary fissions. Similarly, euglena also, it is a favorable conditions to be performed by the such type of binary fissions. It is paramecium also is performed by the favorable conditions, is performed by the transverse binary fission. When we going to performed by the binary fission, they can stop the feeding, attain and increase the size, and what are the cell organelles are going to formation to the double, and next the formation of the division area, first they lost to the what are the cytostome and cytopharynx will be there, just slightly is going to disappear, and here this below of the cytostome area, the small groove will be started, small groove will be continuous. Here, sharing of nucleus, nucleus is sharing, this goes to here, the formation of a nucleus, nucleus also shares. This is a groove is extended till completely extended to divides into the anterior and posterior part, and anterior part to formation of one new paramecium, and the posterior part kill formation of new paramecium. Anterior part of paramecium we called as protor. Anterior part we called as a poster, protor. Posterior part we called as a opisthe. Okay, anterior part is goes to protor and opisthe. Opisthe, the receives only what are the posterior contractile vacuoles. Only received posterior contractile vacuole. Again, it can be formed cytostome, cytopharynx, and here again formation of anterior contractile vacuoles, and again there is a formation of like this. Next, protor, they can receive the anterior contractile vacuole, and what is the mother have the consisting of cytostome and cytopharynx will be there. Again, it can be formation of posterior contractile vacuole, it can be formed by, finally they can formation of the protor and opisthe. Once again I will see that transverse binary fission we are seeing into the paramecium. This is the structure of paramecium. Paramecium be consisting of a here completely orientation by the cilia, it is goes to cytostome, cytopharynx, there is goes to macronucleus, anterior part one the contractile vacuole, remaining part posterior part we call as contractile vacuole will be there. Let us, where unfavorable condition is performed by the transverse binary fission, it here the first that is the karyokinesis will be started, the divide to the karyokinesis, micronucleus and micronucleus into going to divides. Here where is of behind that is goes to cytostome and cytopharynx is slightly going to disappear. This area, the small groove will be started here. The small groove to be extended, the nucleus is get separated, the extended groove to divides into the two daughter paramecians will be formed. Proximal part is the formation of the, we consider as the protor, and posterior anterior part is goes to protor, posterior part is called as opisthe. Protor, the receives the mother one consisting of a cytosome and cytopharynx and anterior contractile vacuoles. And furtherly, the conformation of a posterior contractile vacuole will be formed. That is goes to proter. And what about the opisthe? Opisthe means posterior part of the divisions will be formation of opisthe. Opisthe only receives from mother one only posterior contractile vacuole. And finally, they can formation of cytostome and cytopharynx. And it goes to anterior contractile vacuoles will be formation of furtherly. This is about asexual reproduction is goes to binary fissions. Next one is goes to multiple fission. Multiple fission, basically, we are seeing into the unfavorable conditions. Unfavorable conditions, which is performed by the multiple fission. Multiple fission means, basically, this is we're seeing about entamoeba and amoeba. The nucleus undergoes to repeated divisions. First we goes to nucleus undergoes to repeated divisions is followed by the cytoplasm also divides into the repeated divisions of formation of small lobular structure. In addition to the this type of nucleus, each and every part of the cytoplasm, in addition to the such of a nucleus, the complete like this structure will be formed. Once this is membrane is ruptured, all the organisms is come out. This type of multiple organisms will be come out from the one individual. This type of the asexual reproduction we called as multiple fission. Multiple fission means first we know that the divides division will be occur into the nucleus. Repeated mitotic division results to formation of many nucleus. And each and every nucleus to adjacent to take the small part of the cytoplasm to formation of individual cells will be formed in the membrane. Once the membrane is ruptured, all the organisms are come out. This type of asexual reproduction we call as multiple fission. This type of multiple fission is expressed only where it is unfavorable conditions. We express by the entamoeba, and amoeba is performed by these type of multiple fissions, right? This is a transfer binary fissions by the paramecium. Second one is goes to multiple fission by the entamoeba and amoeba. That is unfavorable condition will be to express. Let us goes to be discussed sexual. Sexual reproduction, the sexual reproduction will be say into the sexual reproduction we are say into the two individuals will be needed, male and female, to formation of a gametes. The gametes will be formed, same type of gametes will be formed is goes to isogamy, and different types of gametes will be formed is anisogamy, and some is hologamy, means we should not formation of gametes. All the organisms be involving into the reproduction area, the type of is goes to hologamy. First is goes to isogamy, anisogamy, and is goes to hologamy. Isogamy means same type of gametes undergoes to fertilization, we call as isogamy. Anisogamy means with a different types of nucleus, different type of gametes, bigger, smaller, that sometimes this goes to anisogamy. And hologamy means we should not formation of a gametes. Whole organism is involving into the formation of fertilizations, we called as hologamy will be there. Next, this type of basically we are seeing the protozoans, two types of is goes to, one is goes to conjugation, second one is goes to syngamy. Conjugation and syngamy will be there. There are two types of sexual reproduction we are seeing here. Conjugation means two sensitile ciliates undergoes to conjugations phenomena to transformation of genetic material one to another to performed by the to results to formation of a individuals. This type of the process we called as a conjugation. Next is goes to syngamy, the union of two different types of gametes to formation together to performed by the produced by the new individuals we called as a singami. It goes to conjugation and a singami will be there. Here, whichermen is explained by the conjugation. Conjugation is we consider as a temporary union of two sensory ciliates to transformation of genetic material to regain what are the loss we performed by the repeated asexual reproduction, what are the vigor and velocity will be lost. First type of vigor means activity power and motility power with regaining by the exchange of genetic materials from the exchange of genetic material formation of new individuals. Those type of process we call as a conjugations. Okay, the conjugation will be takes place. Syngamy also of union of gametes to formation of new individuals will be takes place. But here one more differences we are observing into the asexual and sexual. Asexual reproductions basically simple as it is. Xerox copies will be of repeated copies will be formed here. We call as clones. It is goes to structurally and it goes to genetically similar structures will be there. It goes to asexual reproduction products. That is we call as clone. Called as a clone. We compete to the sexual reproduction. We should not similar to the parental one. It is completely show the sometimes difference will be shown by the this type of sexual reproduction in the protozoa. We are finished about reproduction, asexual and sexual binary fission. It is goes to two binary fissions. It goes to longitudinal and the transverse. Longitudinal binary fissions we are seeing into the euglena. Transverse binary fission we are seeing into the paramecium. It is performed by the favorable conditions. Multiple fission is performed by the unfavorable conditions. Condition sexual reproduction is performed by the unfavorable condition. Repeatedly asexual reproductions will be performed. The loss of energy. The energy will be regaining by the conjugation process. Conjugation process will be there. Here important point is goes to one paramecium is divides into the two. Paramecium divides into the two. It takes only 2 hours of duration. 2 hours of duration is performed by the binary fission. For day only it is performed by the 4 times will be there. This type of divisions we called as symmetogenic. Okay, this type of is goes to homotetogenic divisions. Homotetogenic division. In the case of euglena, we called as symmetrogenic. Symmetrogenic division will be there. Symmetrogenic means single individual is divides in the transverse area. That division we call as symmetrogenic. It is goes to homotetogenic division will be there. This is about reproduction in protozoa. Locomotion and reproduction of the protozoa, we are finished.